Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our biology class. Okay, and we were looking for the lesson from the 9th biology, that is the fundamental unit of life. Okay, we were looking for the lesson that is fundamental unit of life. Okay, the fundamental unit of life is called cell discovery, right? Cell theory, as well as the components of the cell, that everything we have tried to cover, okay? The cell membrane, various things related to the cell membrane we have seen, as well as we have seen the cytoplasm and the VIP organ of the cell is what? Nucleus. That also we had a lot talk on it, okay? So today we are going to talk about the cell organelles, okay? I said you, cell organelles are the tiny components which are present into the gelatinous, fluidy, colorless matrix called as a cytoplasm. Okay, I said you, into the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm contains most amount of water, okay, and organic and inorganic compound substances are present in it. So this is the fluidy material in which this cell organelles or the tiny components are present. Which components those are, students? These cell organelles are, various cell organelles are present in it, such as mitochondria, right? What else? RER and SER means endoplasmic reticulum, okay, as well as Golgi bodies, okay, as well as lysosomes, as well as peroxisomes, as well as centrosomes, as well as vacuoles, ribosomes. So what is tiny components? Very tiny particles, tiny components are present into the cytoplasm. These are floating into the cytoplasm, okay, and these are called as what? Cell organelles. And these cell organelles are having specific shape and sizes. They have a specific shape, they have a specific sizes, as well as they have a different distinct shape also they have, and according to that they also have a different functions. Okay, if you will consider a cell as a factory, okay, or as a factory or as a company which is having some products, which is producing some products, then what is the main function of the factory? To produce any product or to have any good, right? To prepare, synthesize, to have a production of any product, right? As well as the packing of that product, then transportation of that product from that company or from that factory to the other parts. So if we will see the cell as a factory, then nucleus is what? The nucleus will be said as the office of the CEO. You know, students, in any company or in any factory, there is a post of the CEO. CEO is means what? Which is looking after towards the work of the factory, okay? Everything or whatever it is going on into the factory, the CEO is responsible. The long form of the CEO is what? Chief Executive Officer, okay? And Chief Executive Officer will have a specific cabin, okay? So if we'll consider cell as a factory, then CEO office is what? The nucleus. I said you, that is the VIP organelle of the cell or VIP organ of the cell. So CEO is what? CEO's office is what? The nucleus, okay? As well as the main gate is what? If you will talk about both type of cell, plant cell and as the animal cell, then both type of cell will have a fence or will have a gate, main gate, that will be worked as a cell wall, okay? Then the internal means where we enter, the entrance will be what? The cell membrane, okay? And inside the cell membrane there will be the office of the CEO, that is called as what? Nucleus. And what about the other workers who are doing work beside it? But there is one for the CEO, for every CEO, for every month, a very important person, VIP person, there is one PA, okay, personal assistant. So here, in today's topic, in today's session, we are going to talk about the PA of the CEO or personal assistant of the nucleus. Personal assistant of the nucleus, or very important organelle of the cell, or very important worker of the cell factory, that is what? Endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, various cell organelles are there. Means this cell organelle would work like what? The worker of the factory, which will have a specific compartment, which will have a specific size, this will have a specific shape, distinct functions and structure also will be different. So here in today's session, we are going to have a focus mainly on an endoplasmic reticulum. This out of this some cell organelle may be microscopic, means which we have to observe them under the microscope, because with the help of the naked eye it is not possible to see them. Okay, out of that endoplasmic reticulum is also, student, a microscopic cell organelle which we have to observe it under the microscope. Okay, so we will have a talk on endoplasmic reticulum today, which we can say as a personal assistant of a CEO or personal assistant of our nucleus. Okay, so we'll have a talk on a endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so our today's cell organelle is what? Endoplasmic reticulum. There is one diagram. You can see this diagram. Through the diagram, you will be able to understand various things. Where does it occur? This endoplasmic reticulum, where does it occur? If we will talk about the occurrence of the endoplasmic reticulum, then it is mainly occurred into the eukaryotes. Eukaryotes. I said you, what is meant by eukaryotes, right? So no need to say again and again. Eukaryotes means the high organisms or the advanced organism, okay, which contains all type of systems in them or which have all type of cell organelles in it. So it is mainly found in eukaryotes. And exactly into the cell where it is located. If you will see the diagram, students, it is located near, as I said, it's a PA of the nucleus. So mainly it is located near to the nucleus. Okay, you can see. But it is not like that always it will be present near to the nucleus. It's not true. It's untrue. It may be present everywhere into the cytoplasm, because it has to perform a specific function that I shall let you know. So it is mainly found nearby to the nucleus. Okay, it is mainly found nearby to the nucleus, and it can be found haphazardly anywhere into the cytoplasm. So this is the location of the endoplasmic reticulum. See, student, reticulum word is actually derived from the Latin. It's a Latin word. Reticulum means what? The net-like structure. Okay, first keep in mind this. This is very important, that reticulum word is arise from the Latin word. That is called as a reticulum, means for the net-like structure. So if we will have a closer look towards this structure of the endoplasmic reticulum, I said you its location, it is near to the nucleus as well as everywhere into the cytoplasm it is present. It is floating into that matrix. Okay, so how is the structure, students? You can see this is the location I said you. The structure of it is what? You can see the tubular structures, right? That is, endoplasmic reticulum will have two types actually, that I shall let you know very, very soon, in a couple of minutes I shall explain you what is it. So structure, if you will say, it's a tube-like structure. So mainly, if you talk about structure, it has mainly three parts. That is what? Cisternae. Cisternae means what? The fluid-filled sacs. What is it? Fluid-filled sacs are present. Okay, this is the first structure of it. Then second is what? Tubules. Tubules. Tubules means what? Tubes are present. Tubes are present. Okay. And third is what? Vesicle. Vesicle. Vesicles means what? Elongated tube, we can say. Elongated tube. So I hope it is clear for you. You can see even into the diagram. Near to that, whatever the fluid filled sacs you can see, that is called as a cisternae. This is the one part of the endoplasmic reticulum. And one more thing which I forgot to tell you, that is, it is the irregular tube-like structure, okay? It's an irregular tube-like structure and it is a double membranous, okay? It has a double membrane. And irregular tubes are present. Mainly these are into the form of tubes. Why students tubes? Because it has to carry some material, okay? So tube-like structure. So structure if you will talk, then it is double membranous and it's a irregular tubes are present. There are mainly three parts are present to the endoplasmic reticulum, that is first cisternae, which is fluid filled sacs. What fluid is present, that I shall let you know. Then tubules means the long tubes are present, and vesicles if you will talk, then elongated tubes means the tubes, long tubes are present like this. Long tubes are present, okay, like the structure is present. So these are mainly the three parts. If we will talk about the function of the endoplasmic reticulum, what function it has to perform, then function is too much important, students. Please pay attention towards it. I shall let you know about the function it has to perform. But before going ahead, I would let you know that endoplasmic reticulum, if you will see into the figure, you will get to know that one type of endoplasmic reticulum is there. On it, small grain-like structure is present, which give it a rough appearance. Okay, which give some kind of tubules or tubes are present into this diagram, which will have a small grain-like structure, which give it a rough appearance. And that grain-like structure, which are present on the tubes, are called as what? Rough endoplasmic reticulum. So endoplasmic reticulum is divided into two types. That is what? Rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is rough because of the ribosomes present on it. See, students, if you would have watched the nucleus video carefully, you will be able to give the answer of the ribosomes. I said your nucleolus is the structure. Okay, nucleolus is present into the nucleus, which is dense. This nucleolus will have which is made up of RNA and a protein, and into the nucleus the ribosomes are made. So nucleus is called as a factory of the ribosomes. Okay, so what is the function of the ribosome? The ribosome are preparing the proteins. So rough endoplasmic reticulum means what? Will have the ribosomes on it. What will have? It has the ribosomes on it, which give a rough appearance to it. And what is the function of this ribosomes? The function of the ribosome is very easy. It is synthesizing proteins. Okay, so you can see there is a rough endoplasmic reticulum. Beside it, you can see the other tubes which are smooth, which do not have any kind of a rough granules on it or rough appearance on it. That is called as what? Smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, is it secreting anything like RAR? Yes, it is also secreting one thing, and that is called as what? Fat molecules or lipids. Okay, what it is secreting? Fats molecule or lipids are getting secreted by the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So I hope it is clear for you that endoplasmic reticulum is mainly divided into two parts, that is rough endoplasmic reticulum and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, and if you will have a closer look again to the diagram, you will be able to see that some part of the endoplasmic reticulum is attached to the nucleus or nuclear membrane. Because first one part is attached to the nuclear membrane, while other part is attached to the what? Cell membrane or plasma membrane. So I said you, it can be arranged haphazardly everywhere into the cell. So it may be attached sometimes to the nuclear membrane, while some part of it may be attached to the cell membrane. Okay, why it is so, that also I shall explain you. So this is all about the type of the endoplasmic reticulum. If we talk about the function, then from this above two types, it's very clear that it synthesizes what? Protein. For protein synthesis, what synthesizing protein? Synthesizing synthesizing. Protein synthesizing is by the rough endoplasmic reticulum. And lipid synthesizing or fat molecule synthesizing is what? By smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay. What is the third function of it? The third function of this endoplasmic reticulum, I would suggest now. Now, I would not say rough and smooth because I said you already rough and the smooth endoplasmic. Now, whatever the proteins and lipids are secreted by this reticulum, by this endoplasmic reticulum, is not only working like only secretion, it works like hormones also, and sometimes enzymes also. Okay, so it works like hormones also and enzymes also. What is working like hormones and enzymes? Proteins and lipids. Proteins and lipids which are synthesizing into the endoplasmic reticulum are working not only like just a secretion, it's work like sometimes hormones and sometimes like enzymes. Okay, so this is about the third function. What is the fourth function of it? Into the fourth function, if you will talk, then whenever I have told you the cell membrane, I said you the cell membrane is made up of what? I said you cell membrane, if you will have a closer look, then cell membrane is made up of what? Fluid mosaic model, I said you. Okay, fluid mosaic model, in that what I said you? The okay, I said you like this, and this is what? Phospholipid, I said you. Phospholipid, and this is what I said you? Protein. Okay, this is what I said you? For protein. So this phospholipid is what? It's a hydrophilic in nature. Phospholipid is hydrophilic in nature, and this middle one portion, okay, this middle one portion, this is called as protein, which is hydrophobic in nature. So fluid mosaic model, I said you, phospholipid bilayer, I said you bilayer. Why? Because one and two layers are present, and this layers are made up of phospholipid lipids layer. So phospholipid bilayer, I said you. So if we will see protein and lipid again, so if we will talk about the cell membrane, then it helps, or it is synthesizing, or it is help in the production of the cell membrane. It helps in the production of what? Cell membrane, or it is called as a biogenesis process. It helps in the biogenesis. Cell membrane biogenesis. Bio means what? Life. Genesis means what? Production. It helps in the production of the cell membrane. Okay, I hope you understand the fourth point. It helps in the production of a cell membrane, that is called as what? Biogenesis. It helps in the biogenesis. Bio means life, genesis means production. So it helps in the formation of the cell membrane, because cell membrane is composed of what? I said you, lipids and the proteins. So this is the fourth one, important function of it. If we will talk about the fifth function, it works like a network system. It works like network system. Network system. What is mean by network system? If you will see again into the diagram, you will be able to see micropore is there, and through that micropore, the ribosomes are coming out. That ribosomes are helpful for what? Synthesizing proteins. And proteins are mirrored into the cell. Proteins, as I said you, proteins and lipids are present into the cell, are needed for what? Biochemical activities are needed. Wherever it is needed into the cell or out of the cell, whenever it is needed, so to pass from one part of the cell to the other part of the cell, or for if it is needed for to prepare the nuclear membrane, if it is prepared to present into the cytoplasm, whatever the cell organelles are there, wherever the scarcity of the protein or lipid would be there, that will be provided them. So it is working like a network system. Wherever the lipids and proteins are needed, that proteins and lipids are provided by the endoplasmic reticulum. So this is working like what? A network system. As well as it is working like a transportation system too. It helps in the transportation too. How transportation? As I said you just now, what whatever the ribosomes made proteins are sent to the cell membrane. Okay, wherever it is needed into the cytoplasm, whatever the cell organelles are there, wear and tear of the cell organelle. So wherever it is needed, it will be provided. It will be, because I said you, the structure is what, like a tube-like structure. And tube-like structure is why? To provide from one part of the cell organelle to the other part of the cell membrane. So to provide from one part to the other part, transportation function is also performed by the cell, by the endoplasmic reticulum. If we will talk about the seventh bone function, then various biochemical activities are going on. It enhances the various biochemical activities, such as what, student? As I said, you, metabolic processes, nutrition, respiration, circulation, such various metabolic processes are taking place in our body. So those all processes are, means these all processes are chemical processes. But as these chemical processes are taking place in our body, so such a chemical process are called as what? Biochemical processes. So all these metabolic activities, means all these biochemical processes are taking place in our body into the endoplasmic reticulum. So it enhances the biochemical processes. Okay? Biochemical processes. Now, where it is mainly found into the human beings? The smooth endoplasmic reticulum, if we will talk about, then smooth endoplasmic reticulum is mainly found into the liver cells, into the adipose cells of our body, okay, or the intestinal cells of our body, or the intestinal tissue. We have a small intestine, student, okay, small and the large intestine we have. So inside it, inside the wall of the small intestine, inside the lumen of the small intestine, these cells are found. This endoplasmic reticulum is mainly found, okay, or smooth endoplasmic reticulum is mainly found into the small intestinal wall, as well as into the adipose cells or adipose tissue, as into the liver cells also this smooth endoplasmic reticulum is formed. Okay, so if you might be knowing, or if you have heard somewhere, a liver is performing a role of a detoxification of poisonous material and the drugs. How it is possible, student? As I said you, ki this is phospholipid. The upper layer is hydrophobic in nature. The middle one layer is a hydrophilic in nature. So there are some poisons, there are some drugs in our body which are insoluble into the water. Or poisons or drugs are not soluble into the water. Then how our body can get rid of that material? If the poisons and drugs are present into our body, that poisons and drugs, our body must get rid of it. Am I right? The drugs and this poisonous material must not remain in our body. This is hazardous. And how our body can get rid of it? Our body can get rid of it by the urinary system or by the excretory system of our body. But if some drugs and some poisonous material is unable to dissolve into the water, then into the liver cells, there is smooth endoplasmic reticulum which secretes specific kind of enzyme that will turn that insoluble, water insoluble particles into the water soluble particles. Understood, student? So that smooth endoplasmic reticulum is mainly present into the liver cell, because the function of the liver cell is what? To detoxify the drugs and the poisonous material. So if we will talk about it, then rough endoplasmic or a smooth endoplasmic, both endoplasmic reticulum has a main function, detoxification of poisonous material and drugs is taking place by the endoplasmic reticulum. It may be rough or it may be smooth. So this is the main function of the endoplasmic reticulum. I think I have explained you about the structure of the endoplasmic reticulum, which is into the form of tubes, vesicles and cisternae, I said you, as well as the location. It is found near to the nucleus, as well as haphazardly anywhere into the cytoplasm it is found. It is mainly found into the eukaryotes, okay, and it has a specific structure for its function. Okay, and there are mainly two types of endoplasmic reticulum, that is rough endoplasmic reticulum and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is for synthesizing protein because of the presence of the ribosomes on it, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum enhances the process of the lipid formation. Okay, and both are working like a hormone and the enzymes. Okay, so the mechanical support also it is providing. It forms a network system. Phospholipid bilayer is present, which helps in the membrane biogenesis. Okay, it helps into the cell membrane biogenesis process. Okay, as well as it forms a network system, transportation system. It forms then biochemical processes, metabolic processes are taking place into the endoplasmic reticulum, as well as detoxification of poisons and the drugs are also taking place into the endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, students. See, various times we take various kinds of medicines. Okay, and some elements of that medicines are not needed for our body. Some elements are needed, but some are not needed. So those elements our body is getting rid by the excretory system when it dissolves into the water. But some are unable to dissolve into that body. So that solubility can be given by the endoplasmic reticulum. So I hope you understand about the endoplasmic reticulum. And in next class, I shall explain you about the further cell organelle or the next cell organelle. Thank you so much.